She is shown through I-1 with another rider.
Okay.
I just started riding her again about 3 months ago.
Okay, and to what level have you shown?
I showed her a 4-1.
Okay, and that's the highest you've shown?
No, yeah. Actually, I did 4-3 20 years ago.
Oh, yeah. Do you remember?
No.
What was I doing 20 years ago?
Yeah.
Okay, so what's our goal?
Her shortfalls, I guess, are...
No, what's our goal? What are we gonna be doing next year?
Oh, next year, fourth level.
Okay, do you think you'll be able to do 4-3?
I would hope, but, you know, eventually precinct George and...
Good.
I'm gonna get my silver.
And what do you do the best?
Her lateral works probably the best.
Okay, trot and canter?
Trot and canter.
Does that include pirouettes?
She can do pirouettes.
I know she can.
I can do them, but I haven't done them that much.
Okay.
So, how good they are, I don't know.
Okay.
You'd have to ask Debbie, she's seen it.
Okay. And can you do the short canter pretty well?
Yes.
Do the circle?
Yeah, the circle of the, yeah, that's, she did really good on that.
And the changes?
Changes can be really good or rough. She either is late behind or she'll stick both hind legs. It's hit or miss. A lot of it's just straightness issue, I think.
Okay, I was gonna say, do you have a sense of what to do to make them better, or is it literally only if God's helping?
My timing isn't that great yet.
And that's the secret, the changes.
Right, so a lot of it, I'm sure, is me and then her adding in the pirouette.
Okay, let's go to walk. And I always like to see if people know what circles look like. I'm usually disappointed.
Yeah.
Now, just tell me what you think of this walk.
For her, she tends to not have a real good walk.
Okay, I want you to be a judge. What do you think about this walk? Not for her, but on the stick, on the side or standing.
Normally, she probably...
No, you keep saying her.
For me, I don't know. Probably a 5, she's kind of...
Look at the signature right here.
I tried to... Good. Now, it looks a little rigid.
Okay.
Now, can you take for a moment a little more sample? Do you need to have that much curve?
No.
She's just kind of sitting down against the curve, is the feeling I get.
No.
I'd like to have a sense that you're not just letting her lay on the rein and be in one place, but you're communicating. Please circle. Circles don't have straight lines in them. That's the thing. There are continuous curves. Now, now just bend her a tiny bit more left. Just bend her, I'm so sorry. Right, just a little, get her to give the right side of her jaw a little bit. Yep. Now give just a tiny bit. Elastic arm. I'd like you to stop in front of me. A little bit of a crook in your wrist. may have a lot more pressure for a moment,
mm-hmm.
but then try to be a little cautious.
Okay.
Okay? And she's not going to be more elastic than you are.
Okay.
Okay? So, but just think about rubber bands. You can have little skinny, weak rubber bands, or you can be have big, fat, strong rubber bands. But they're all rubbery. I'm not saying you never resist against the horse, but in general, we want a suppleness from her, not a rigidity, but we've got to have a suppleness from ourselves. You've still got a container. Good. Letting her move your arm the way I move your arm, but also containing her a little bit. Now let's go to trot again. Bending a little right. Keep her together. I'm not saying let her be long and strung out. A little bit rounder. Good. Good. Just sometimes bend her a little right and just, yeah, there. Don't drop her. Elastic. Good. Now is this the trot? Outside rein helps the turn. Good. Now, slow the trot for two or three strides. Supple, bend just a little. Yeah. And now bigger trot again. And now slow a little bit. Supple, supple, hold. A little bit rounder. Bending a little. Oh, keep it slow. But keep, you see how she grabs against you? You want to anticipate that a little, just a little bend or maybe a little shaking of the bit that just says, not your hip, my hip. You want a bit there, you go buy your own. It's not yours to grab and hold. Good. Yeah. And when you get to E, change to the center of the circle, a half circle to F. Followed by a half circle to B. Half circle to X. Half circle B. You should be strike one stride straight on the center line. Bending left, you need to adjust your rein. And you could change your posting diagonal just for fun. Good. And let's canter. Bend her a little. Shorten the canter. Right rein a little against the neck. Don't put your right leg back. I don't want her haunches in. Do not put your right leg back. That's a little better. Now just soften her up a little in front. Just loosen that jaw a little. Yeah. Good. And now an extra short canter. Supple, shorter, wide. Good. And normal canter. Diagonal to F and a flying chain. Boy. Medium, supple in the jaw, and colon. Little apples, bend her a little to the right, that's plenty collected, not more. From K, half cast to the center line. And straight on the center line. Always jump. Now, on the ball side, or not just on the ball, but I want to see a little more shoulder pull. A little, don't bend the neck more. Shoulders a little to the right. Good. Keep your active on the track. And from K, half pass to the center line, and I want you to finish in that little bit of shoulder four. Shoulder four, shoulders, keep the canter, and now shoulder four. Active. Nope, she's still a teeny bit hunched in there. Come to walk. Now, you may know this, but you want to think about the fact when you're in this halt there, home. When you're half passing to the center line, normally the horse's haunches have a tendency to go one more stride than you're asked for. So if you ask, if you stop adding sideways here, they'll take one more step. Okay? So when you're coming to the center line, if you just sort of, you know, you're going sideways and you're using your aids and then you say, okay, now go straight ahead, you'll end up a little haunches in. Okay. Even more than normal. So you want to be riding, drawing almost on the center line, and go one more stride. I'm going to stop asking for an outside leg. I'm going to keep directing her to the center line so that she ends up in that little shoulder pull. what it translates into, if you just stop, we're caring, and when you go to ask for the change, I'm right, we got the change to the left, it's usually just a little closing of the right, right, that's closing, maybe move right hand a little bit towards the neck, shoulders, you know, and then left leg, close the left. I'm exaggerating it just a little bit, but ultimately, we want that horse to be doing the change. Okay? And I always tell people when I teach this, you need to go home and just practice like we did, just riding some single changes, focusing on not taking that inside. Good. Okay, just let her walk around once. Is it going to rain all weekend?
Yep.
Oh, well, fun. And then is it coming to the east where I... We had 5 inches on Monday. Tuesday.
Oh, God.
I know, that's what the people told me yesterday. I know snow, that's it.
Position her a little more to the right. Good. She doesn't need to be rounder than this. You don't want that fold to disappear. Yeah? Good. Straight ahead. When you get over here, straight ahead. Sorry. See how far you are from the wall?
Mm-hmm.
That was an excellent turn on the haunches. Okay, now you're gonna get a little gutsier for your pirouette. Do you do any half steps or anything?
Yes.
I want you, no, don't, what are you doing in the middle of the ring like that? I want you starting right on the wall. Now, let's turn across into the other wall. I want you to think about half steps. I don't want you to do it, but just think about half steps. And yeah, it teaches them to step in place. So I want you to think about the little energized half-holes that make very give her a little hole to begin with, a half hole, and then you don't take back, you take your hands in this case to the right. So is she being active? Walk straight, don't do it, don't do it. Can you show me some half step? Want to be thinking half steps before you start. Now give turn. Turn. Yes! Woo! Click save. Click save. Okay?
Okay.
So I had some horses who weren't very active, and I never got good pirouettes until I could do some piaf. Because the piaf taught them to go in, you know, move kind of in place. Whereas they had these big strides that they couldn't sort of think about handling them. Of course, I could have probably trained them better, too. Okay, let's go straight ahead. Now, you're letting her get stuck deep. You've got to really be careful of that. Be careful of your curve brain. See how deep she is? Let her pull up. Let her pull up. Give her a little. Last weekend with Jo Hinneman, who's an amazing trainer.
Love him.
But I almost walked out. PREs, or I don't know if it's Lusitano, it was an Iberian one. And he wanted to get much too deep, as they so often do. And so the rider kept doing this with the curb brain. That is so stupid. You see it so much. You were almost. Now, I have no problem if the horse starts to get stuck deep and you close your leg and nothing happens or they get quick with giving them a little up. But the last thing you want to do is do that with a curb rein. So you go to pull up and that's pulling the curb rein. So you do this and you're literally telling the horse to do this. If you're going to, first of all, if your horse gets too deep, make sure you aren't on the curb, because the curb is what makes him deep.
Right.
You know, the curb pulls the head in, pure and simple. So number one, make sure you aren't on the curb. And number two, if your horse is still getting a little stuck down here, and you're gonna do this, which is fine, do it with a snap.
Okay.
Make sure you loosen the curb, which may mean short the snap, or whatever. Make the curb looser than the snap.
Right.
Okay, please don't do that, guys. I see it, you know, I sit down there in Wellington and I watch all these classes and these horses are going around and the riders are doing this with a curb.
First thing.
Stupid. I have a few pet peeves. That's one of the big ones. Okay.
What is your opinion?
I just feel so bad for the horses. Because the riders are saying, get your head up, but actually they're saying, get your head down, and they keep doing it over and over. Okay, so we have a nice uphill kind of walk. Turn left straight across the arena. I want you to look at her head in the mirror. Look in the mirror. Does it look like what it feels like?
No, it looks like
it looks better than it feels.
Right.
Exactly my point. Yep. Are you on your sample? You could have just a little more sample. Good. Now, you know, when you're walking, I would have basically hardly any curve. You may need to take it up a little bit when you go on. That's fine. You can adjust them. They don't have to stay the same. Okay. Let's go to trot.
Okay.
good. Now, she's starting to get a little deep. Now, she may be a little tired, so it's going to be even easier for her to get deep. You've got quite a bit of curve. And I don't know, maybe you need it. But my goal is always to use as little as I can. Good. Trot. Point her nose to me. Good. Oh, give a little. Ah. What do you think?
Thumbs up.
Half circle, half back again. She's a little haunted in there. Giving. Forehand. Kids, she wrote a lot better than I. She's 3 years older. And I have no idea. yelled at me that day when I was probably 11 or 12 or something. He yelled over when we were riding together, and I can still hear her voice. If it's comfortable, it's too slow! Yep. And you know, I'd be out there riding around and kind of going, you're good. Suddenly realize, yeah, there's no power whatsoever.
Right.
You need to have that in your
right.
You know? Because true, if it's comfortable, it's too slow.
Right.
And when you're out there really riding your cross, it's not going to be good enough.
Right.
And you've got to push yourself because you're bringing her down to do your comfort level instead of challenging yourself to move up to her quality. But it's got to be more bold.
Okay.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
And for me, I would rather you ride really good trot and lose it.
Okay.
Die in there.
Right.
You know, or go to camp. You know? So, you know, maybe you don't trot so long, but you make sure, I want you to go out and show me your very, her, not yours, her very best trot. Without the curve. One degree more. There. Yeehaw, not more. That's plenty, that's plenty. Easy, easy. Good. A little rounder, gently, a little right bend. A little right bend. Yup. Bend a little. Now we're getting a little dinky. Easy on. Good. That's good. Not more. Stop. Hold. Good girl. Yeah. She's going my way, like the other way.
Yes, she did.
That's your normal. Center line. Coming down the center line, it's the judge's last opinion. Last thought about you. Good. And fall. That's almost too much. Easy, easy. You should move the bit. Just a little is your hole. It's a perfect square hole. Love it.
Very good.
That's enough. You've got to find that. Okay? I mean, the difference in what you've got is huge.
Right.
Now, you've got to look carried away. And then you've got to be a little uncomfortable and loose. My arms don't work quite so well. But you've got to keep, you know, you can do it.
Right.
You absolutely can do it. You remember when you first started sitting trot?
Yeah.
Was it awful?
No.
It wasn't terrible? You must have been on a comfortable horse. Or your legs been really slow.
Usually it's really slow.
Yeah. So anyway, you know.